Hey guys, welcome back to Gyro Technology Solutions. Been a hot minute and we're going to keep on going. So I'm going to do a video today where I'm following up essentially with the basic security video. And so you had the minimal security, which is setting up a basic username and password for the Elasticsearch and Kibana. And then you take it a step further by doing basic security where you're encrypting the traffic between the Elasticsearch nodes if you have multiple nodes. And then this last step we're going to talk about today and setting up basic security plus secured via HTTPS traffic. So that means is that you're going to have secure traffic between your Kibana instance and your Elasticsearch nodes. And you're also going to have secure traffic. You can also have secure traffic between your Kibana and your web browser. And you're also going to have secure traffic between your Beats and your Kibana and also your Elasticsearch. So without further ado, I'm going to jump straight into this because you guys know I like going straight into the technical stuff. And just follow along the best you can. And this is going to be this first part is what I'm going to cover because I don't want this to be a super long video. But I'll go ahead and just give you a brief overview. So we're going to run this command and it's going to give us some HTTP certificates. We have to fill in some information to kind of sort of push through that. But we're going to generate the certificates and then we're going to copy them to our other nodes over here. So we have right here Lab Scene 1 and then I'm going to have to copy the other certificates to Lab Scene 2 and Lab Scene 3. And then we're also going to have to copy Kibana's certificates into its little directory. And then from there, we're going to have to add these lines in to each Elasticsearch node so that it knows to use the HTTP .b12 certificate. And then from there, we're going to start Elasticsearch, and I'm going to end this video there and then pick up with encrypting the HTTP client communications for Kibana in the next video. So it's going to be a three-part series, basically, or three-part video. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into it. First thing I'm going to do is navigate to my user, share at Elasticsearch bin. And under this directory is all your scripts to run for different things with Elasticsearch. So I'm just going to go ahead and do Elasticsearch and then do attack cert util. And then I'm going to do HTTP. And I'm going to cheat a little bit. I'm going to bring over my document that I've already pre-created. It's going to take this a second to run. All right, so it says generate a CSR. We know we do not want to generate a CSR. Use an existing CA. So I'm using the built-in or the local CA to this server to do all my signing for these certificates. And this is a lab, so if you have a production environment, highly suggest you use whatever CA is local or internal to your business. I'm going to go ahead and run over to my cheat sheet and grab it. And so typically your CA is going to be located under the directory, under the user share Elasticsearch directory. So make sure you keep the location in mind. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and enter. And then it says put the password in for your CA. So in a previous video, I pointed that out. So make sure that if you do have a password, you remember it and you put it in here. So I'm going to put my password in. And then it's going to go straight into the validity period. So if I'm following the web page here, we're going to go up and then it's going to jump right into that right there where it says validity period. And so right here it says 5 years. I'm going to keep it the default. It says generate certificate per node. And I'm going to say yes. All right. And again, I'm going to kind of use my cheat sheet here a little bit. I'm going to copy directly from my Google Doc. And then you're just going to enter that same thing again. If you have multiple names or whatever for your host, then you can go ahead and plug all that stuff in here. So if it's like Lab Scene 1, then you also have Lab Scene 1 with the domain name on it. Plug whatever in there that needs to go in there per the systems on your network. All right, and that's going to copy that in there. I'm just going to enter again, and that's going to save it. Well, I'm sorry, it's not going to save it. It's going to ask you, is this correct? Then save it. And then it's also going to ask you about your IP. So I'm going to grab my IP from over here and then paste it in there. And it's going to be whatever IP is on this for the server that you're getting this HTTP set up for. And then I'm going to hit enter twice. And then is that correct? Yes. And then do you want to make any changes? So make sure you don't just enter button through all this. Make sure you actually read the questions because no, we don't want to change any of the options now. And then do we want to do additional certificates? Yes, we do. So here's the second node name. So once again, I'm going to copy and paste, and this it can get a little tedious. But just bear with it. Copy again, hit enter twice, Is that correct? Yes. And then we're going to add in our second IP for our second node. Enter twice. Is this correct? Yes. And then do you want to change any of these options? Nope. And then we want to do, and keep in mind that I have three nodes, so you're only going to do this for the amount of nodes that you need done. So just keep that in mind as you go. And so I'm going to do my third node. Is that correct? Yes. And then we're going to do our IP. Is that correct? Yep. Do we want to make any changes? Nope. Do we want to any additional certificates? Nope. And it says, if you wish to use a blank password, simply press enter. Well, I'm going to go ahead and put a password in, even though this is a lab, and I'm going to confirm it. So this way, whenever you go to install the certificates, then you have to put that password in. So it's got some level of security on it. All right, it's going to ask you, where do you want to put this output file to? You're going to just, I'm just going to put it under the default directory. And then so you're going to do basically cd to the parent, to the next directory up, and then do ls, and bam, it's that beautiful red zip file right there. If you want a little bit better view, bam, there you go. All right, so from this point, we're going to go ahead and do an unzip. So I'm going to unzip it. All right, and then the ls, so you see the new, well, actually make this a better view. So you see where it has this Elasticsearch right here. And then it's got the, and then there's a zip file. You can basically delete that if you want to. Here's your Kibana. And then those two are the directories we're going to work with for the moment. So Elasticsearch, you're actually going to copy your HTTP 12, P12 certificates to the corresponding nodes. And then Kibana, you're just going to copy directly into the Kibana sitting on that node, on your current node, should I say. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and do CD Elasticsearch. LS, so you see that it's got each node that I've already told it to do. So now we're going to cd into lab, and we're going to pick the first one, LS, and this is where your HTTP .p12 file is sitting. So let's go ahead and do a copy, and just so you know, I always keep the original files just in case something happens, things do go wrong, files get deleted, whatever. So I always keep the original file in that directory just to make sure that if I need it again, I can get it again. So I'm going to do copy HTTP 12, and we're going to throw that guy right into the Elasticsearch directory under Etsy. All right, and then we're going to cd over there. Do ls. All right, and then always make sure you check your permissions. I think this one's already good to go since it was created here. So right here you have HTTP .p12, and the owner is root, and the group is Elasticsearch, and then it can be read by everybody. So make sure those are in place. All right, so now the fun part. We're going to cd back to user, share, Elasticsearch, ls. Oh, I'm sorry, I got to go one more directory deep. All right, and then we're going to do cd lab scene 2, ls. All right, so here's our second HTTP.p12 certificate. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're going to do SCP, HTTP 12, and then we're going to do Dylan at, this is going to take my, sometimes I don't have numlock enabled and it jumps across the screen. All right, so I'm going to do 57.71, which is the IP of my next node, and we're going to copy this over into my home directory over there since I have permissions for that. And we're going to put my password in for that specific user login, and then there it goes. All right, so now we're just going to do, we're going to clear this out. Now we're going to do ls, and then there it sits. So here's something important. Do a ls tag leh so you can look at the actual permissions. So this is owned by Dylan and the group of Dylan, and it's already read by, anybody can read it already. So I go ahead and do the chown root and then do http12. So it's owned by root, and I'm going to change group to Elasticsearch, and the same thing, so that way we stay uniform. All right, and then once that happens, I'm going to double tap up on the keyboard. So that's going to show me that that's all good. And I'm going to move the HTTP 12 certificate to the Etsy Elasticsearch directory. All right, and then we're going to do the same thing. I know this is slightly tedious. Bear with me. So then we're going to lab scene 3 folder. Excuse me, it's in the same thing. So I'm actually going to up arrow this since it's already there. I'm just going to change this IP since we already know where everything's going. All right, copied over. So we're going to skip over to our lab scene 3. LS, HTTP 12 is sitting right there. So again, I'm not going to look at the permissions. I already know what it's going to look like. So I'm going to do chown root HTTP 12 and then change group to Elasticsearch. And then I'm going to go ahead and double check it just to make sure. But yes, it is readable by everybody already. So I'm going to move that to the corresponding folder. And then bam. So now if we ls.lah and then do etsy Elasticsearch, bam, there it's sitting right there, safe and sound. All right. So what have we done so far? Just as a quick recap. So we generated the certificate. We used the command to generate the certificates. And then we put in our password, our path for the CA. We put in our password for the CA. We gave it a 5-year validity. I know this has 90 days. And then we created a certificate per node. And then we copied each corresponding certificate to its corresponding node. All right. And then right here it says, after generating the certificate for each of your nodes, enter the password. So we gave that a password a moment ago. And then we unzipped it. And then we went ahead and moved all these files over their corresponding nodes. So here's the next step. We're going to go back to Lab Scene 1. I'm going to go CD. And this is saying change, edit, basically edit your Elasticsearch YAML file. So I'm going to go over to etsy Elasticsearch, but you didn't have to do that. But anyway, I'm already in that directory now, so I'm going to do nano Elasticsearch, if I can type correctly, .yaml. All right, and then here is the YAML file of that for my Elasticsearch configuration. I've set this up in previous videos, different IPs, same thing. But anyway, I've already copied and pasted this. So basically, you copy these two lines right here, and then you paste them at the bottom of the config file. And I've already pasted these, obviously. I'm just going to uncomment them. And one thing I'll take of note is right here, they only have the certificate sitting there. It says path, though. So I went ahead and put the full path of that certificate. So go ahead and do that. I've had issues where it hasn't worked before, so once you do that, it should work. So I'm going to go ahead and control O that. I'm going to go ahead and do a systemctl. I'm sorry. You know, I actually skipped the step. So add the password for your private key to the Elasticsearch settings. So once you add those two lines and uncomment them, uncomment them if you already had them there from whatever reason. All right, and then I'm going to go back to user, share, Elasticsearch, bin. And here's the fun part. So grab this right here and highlight from Elasticsearch over to the end of password. Copy that. And then make sure you put a ./ right there first, and then copy in that, paste in that command. So you're going to do that. All right, it's going to ask you for a password. I had already done this, and so it's asking me to override. I'm just going to go ahead and say yes, override it, and I'll put in my password. And bam, you're done with that. So systemctl restart, Elasticsearch. And so that's going to do that for that node. And then we got to do the same thing for these other two nodes. So we've already moved the file in there. We're going to go ahead and do nano etsy Elasticsearch, Elasticsearch.yaml. All right, and then we're going to skip down to the bottom. And again, I had already done this, so bear with me. If those lines aren't there, go ahead and copy them there. And then go ahead and control O it, and then exit out. And then again, cd user share Elasticsearch bin. Actually, I don't want to do that and confuse anybody. So sometimes I put the ./ there to begin with, but again, I'm just going to hit copy, paste. And then we're going to overwrite this because again, I had already done it before. Good there. Awesome. All right. So now we're going to do systemctl restart Elasticsearch. I spelled Elasticsearch wrong. Typing too fast. And then we're going to let that restart. And then now I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing to the very last one. So we're going to do nano etsy Elasticsearch, Elasticsearch.yaml. Bam, bam, bam. Okay, so I never even uncommented those, so that's fine. All right, then I'm going to go ahead and cd over to user share Elasticsearch bin ./ for the last time, hopefully. Copy, paste. Yes, and then do all this fun stuff. Awesome. So systemctl, restart, Elasticsearch. And you know it should be working correctly if all your Elasticsearch instances restarted correctly. If there's any kind of error, usually Elasticsearch will straight up just fail. And so just make sure that whenever you're doing this, you can always get back into a systemctl status Elasticsearch. And then it should be up and running and happy whenever it decides to come up. I'll go ahead and go over to the lab scene 2, and that did. And then lab scene 3 is still working on that one. All right, and then see that right there is running. It might just take it a moment. All right, there it goes. Perfect. All right, guys, so I'm going to stop this video here. And again, I know it's been a while since I uploaded a video. And by the way, thank you to all the new subscribers that I've gotten in the last several months. It's been awesome. So I decided, hey, I need to jump back on there and start doing videos again like I was doing before. But anyway, guys, that's all I got for this part of it. And then I'm going to pick back up straight up with the encrypting HTTP client communications for Kibana. And we're going to push on from there. But thanks, guys, for watching, and look out for the next video.